So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. That'll be taken about a yard deep, and this will be brought out to the 25 as Taylor elects to not return it. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. On the give, this is Harris. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards. Boy, the offensive line there, that was a thing of beauty to watch them block.
I love how you give a little appreciation for those big guys up front, and well-deserved. But how about the execution behind them? You can see the hours of practice that have gone into it. Great pocket by the running back. Quarterback puts it right in the perfect spot. Great mesh point by them. The timing on point, the run even better.
On first down, Newton. He'll let this go for the end zone. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
A second and 10 now. Third quarter action from Foxborough. Here's a toss right side with White. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. James White, 34 yards. And the Patriots add on to their lead.
For the extra point.
That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for the offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And their halftime hole now even deeper, and they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Now it's Ryan. He's got a first down past the 30. And all the way up to the 33-yard line. 15 yards on the play, first down.
And the Falcons.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football. And right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try to get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
How about a guy proving his worth in different ways? Had the big play in the run game to play before. This time, they go right back to him in the passing game, and he comes through with yet another big play. That's why you work out so hard in the offseason, so you can stay on the field and accumulate big plays.
And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. And with that, we want to remind you, it takes all of us to fight cancer. That's why the NFL and the American Cancer Society teamed up to create Crucial Catch. They've been working together for over a decade, and you can join the fight. Get screened today. Visit NFL.com/crucialcatch. And that, Charles, obviously a very worthy endeavor.
No doubt about it. Everybody that I know, probably everyone you know, affected in some way or some form. Everyone wants to support this cause.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. He's going to have the hook up to Gage. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. It's caught, Jones. Yeah, he's got to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive? Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. Again, Ryan. Looking downfield for Jones. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive.
The ball carrier.
And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and nine looming. Play number nine on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. Fine work by the Patriot D there, and it's fourth down.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on third down.
It's now fourth down.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. They're going on fourth down. It's Ryan. A slant to Jones. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Not often do fourth down conversions result in 23 yards, but that's the case here. First down. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. They go back to the ground now with Smith. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown.
Touchdown.
A 16-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons cut into that lead. And they drew up the counter there. It worked. They're glad they drew up the counter.
And a lot of times what you're trying to do is just simply get the defense moving in one direction. It doesn't take much. Even one step's enough. Get them going in one direction and then cut back against the grain and let your running back finish it off and get the work done.
Dan Quinn's told his offense, let's try and get two more. They'll try and run it up the middle. And he will find the end zone again. So he gets the touchdown and the two-point conversion. And that'll cut this deficit down a little bit further. Back now in Foxborough, where the fourth quarter will begin with a kickoff following the score on the final play of the third quarter.
Sterling Buckrichter to kick off.
That is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. On the return, it's Taylor. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
23-yard line.
The pass. Pats at the line, ready to go. Now, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
3 yards the gain there, second down. Ball at the 26, second and seven. They will run with White out of the shotgun. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. A gain of 13, it's a first down. I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
13-yard gain yet again, just like last play. From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. They find some open field here. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. He's got the first down inside the 10. And finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line.
First and goal at the 8-yard line.
Left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll try to run it in, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. James White, his second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Patriots add 6 to their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. You can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Now Newton. And this one incomplete. So they wait for the two. They don't get it.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us. Because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
So they hit the ball before it went 10 yards. I know that's tough, but you got to stay disciplined.
It is difficult because you're so eager to go get the football. It's that type of a play, but you're exactly right. Have to have the discipline to let it go 10 first.
A handoff to Smith. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
10 yards.
At any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before that he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. It's a first down on a gain of 10. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Here's Ryan. This will be caught inside the 10. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. It's Calvin Ridley on the receiving end from Matt Ryan. And the Falcons get a bit closer. Okay, so they got the score. Do you go for one here and save the possible two-point conversion for later?
I think you do, because if you go for two here and you don't get it, that's deflation. Now you wonder why you're even going for it. Take the easy one now and come back and try and get it later.
Here's Ryan. And that one is caught. So they convert here and don't look now, but this one's back to a one-score game.
Falcons 16.
A little less than 90 seconds to go. This will be an onside kick. And this is secured by the Patriots. A tough one there. They certainly wanted that when they needed it, but they didn't absolutely have to get it. They still do have three timeouts.
You're exactly right. They had to attempt it. But even though they didn't get it, as you noted, with three timeouts, if they can get these stops on defense, all hope is not lost.
First down, here's White. Now Cam, option left. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Good gain there on first down. That keeps him in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front. Good blocking, nice hole for him, ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They're in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
Not in any rush offensively. It's a loss. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts, as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Asiasi, the tight end. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A big pickup there, and without question, that should be more than enough to wrap this one up. And this defense, they needed that one more stop to have any chance, but that completion, that's likely going to seal their fate.
And you could hear it in your voice, that one more stop.
I feel their pain.
Oh, it was so important. They just didn't get it done. Wow, what a way to finish this one off.
He'll fight his tight end here, Asiasi.